गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 9th चैप्टर 4 वैल्यूज एंड डेटा टाइप्स। एज इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टोकन्स लाइक कॉन्स्टेंट्स, लिटरल्स, पंचुएटर्स, आइडेंटिफायर्स एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कीवर्ड्स दैट आर द रिजर्व वर्ड्स फॉर जावा like public, static, int, float. Today we will discuss identifiers. Identifiers means used to give different names in a Java program, like we are using the class name, we are using a variable name, and these identifiers we will discuss through page number 56. Start with term identifiers. Identifiers are used to name different components. Components means parts of a program, such as variables, methods, objects, etc. Variable means if we are using a program to find the area of rectangle, we are using length and breadth. So length and breadth is a variable name. If we are using a program to find the sum of two integers, then we will take two variables A and B. So A and B are identifiers. Similarly, if we write the class name public class area, so area is a identifier. If we will write public class display, so display word is a identifier. Same way, if we are taking any method name, if we are taking any object name, that all come in the category of identifiers. See the example, the program we have created in BlueJ, public class calculation. Now what is calculation? It is a name of class, so it is an identifier. Next, we have written int a is equal to 10, then what is a? Identifier, that is a variable name. Next we have written int b is equal to 20. Now what is b? Identifier, that is variable name. Next we have written int sum is equal to a plus b to find the sum of two numbers. So what is sum? Identifier. So this way, the name that we are using in a program for method name, for variable name, for object name, for class name, that all come in the category of identifiers. Clear, students? Now, students, we will discuss some rules for Java identifiers. So, see the students. Number one, an identifier can consist of any combination of letters, means any number of letters will be there. Like we can write the class name as area of square, that is a long combination of letters. It can consist of digits also. The underscore character you can put in between the characters, like roll, underscore, number. And it consists of dollar sign also. Clear? Number two, an identifier cannot begin with a digit, means with number you can't start identifier. For example, you write one calculation, that one digit is a wrong over there. Next, number three, identifier may be of any length, means we have done in first rule any combination of letters, so it may be of any length, means long length name you can take in a identifier. Next one, number four, both uppercase and lowercase letter can be used in naming an identifier. Means, whatever the name you are taking for variable or class, it may be in uppercase also and it may be in lowercase also. Or it can be a combination of uppercase and lowercase characters. Number five, Java is a case sensitive, which means two different names that differ only in upper and lower case characters are considered to be different identifiers. Means that if you are taking the class name in upper case or if you are taking the class name in lower case. Both upper case and lower case is having the different meaning because Java is a case sensitive language very close to these characters. Maybe means both upper case and lower case character is different. Therefore, first word total, that all in small letter. Second word, capital T and rest are small letters. Number third, only first word capital, third word capital and fourth word capital. And number four, all words are capital, all are different identifier. Means you can take all different these words as a class name or variable name. They can have a different meaning. Now see the examples of some valid identifiers. Number one, student underscore name means you can use the underscore name in between. Like I have given you the example of roll number, roll underscore num. Number two, dollar, it can be start with a dollar sign and it may consist of digit also or uppercase character also. Number third, file, tree means digit can come at the end but it will not be used at the starting. Number four, underscore age means you can use the underscore character at the starting of the variable or method name also. Number five, total, full word is in capital letter or uppercase, this is also valid. And number six, this underscore is, underscore a, underscore very, underscore long, underscore identify. Means it consists of very long length, so it is an also a valid identifier. This way you can use the different, you can use underscore at the starting also, you can start with dollar sign also, you can put digit in between also. So these are the different examples of valid identifiers. See the students, examples of invalid identifiers. Firstly, THIS, this, it is a Java keyword, means you can't use Java keyword as a identifier. For example, if you will write public class static or you will write public class int. So int and static is a class name, but this is an invalid because it is a keyword. So you can't use keyword as a identifier. Number two. Now what is the problem in number two? Total, then space is there and amount. Now why it is invalid? Space is not allowed in identifier. In place of space you can put underscore or you can join the word. You can write total amount in a combined form or you can write total underscore amount. Clear? Number third, 1m underscore eng. Now you can see in between underscore sign is there, but what is the problem? It starts with the digit. Now the reason is identifier name cannot begin with the digit. Now see number four, total hyphen marks. Now you can see the student, what is the problem? Hyphen sign is not allowed. So which is allowed? Special character other than dollar or underscore are not allowed, means only you can put underscore sign in between or you can use the dollar sign. Any other special character, like you can say ampersand sign, asterisk sign, percentage sign, hash sign, at the rate, these, any special characters are not allowed in identifiers. Clear students? So students, today we have discussed what is identifier, what are the different rules for naming an identifier, some valid identifiers, some invalid identifiers, and we have discussed the define also. So students, revise this topic carefully, go through the examples, go through explanations, and in the next video we will come with next topic. Thank you very much.